there, welcome to Inquiring Minds. My name is Doug and I'm back with another Pen Resurrection Sunday video. And yes, it's another Parker Vacumatic. This made in Canada 1946 Parker 51 Vacumatic with a gold cap. I've had a few disappointing resurrections lately, but this was very satisfying because I used what I learned from having the Vacumatic pump on the Silver Pearl Vacumatic explode on me.
And it exploded.
To take care of this one properly. And this pen was pretty beat up and ugly when I got it, but now it shines and writes like new. So let me share how I did it with you right now. And this is what the pen looks like after restoration. I'm pleased to say that this pen is officially back from the dead. Now let's look at what it looked like before I started working on it. So before I do any restoration work on this Parker 51 that I've just received, I thought I'd give it an overview here to see what it looks like before. This is a made in Canada gold cap with the pinstripes, a non-blue diamond split arrow clip, really nice jewel. There are some scratches on the line cap and of course corresponding scratches on the hooded section, and there's a date code here. It says made in Canada, and just there it says 6 and there's no dots, so that's the fourth quarter of 1946. This is a Vacumatic and it feels like the sack is intact, but I have had this pen apart already and that sack is relatively old and sort of folding in on itself, so it doesn't always snap back. So I'm going to replace the sack. I'm going to polish up the barrel and the hood and get that cap back gleaming again. And now I'll share some time-lapse video of the restoration process. So before I start polishing the hood, the barrel, and the blind cap, I thought I'd take a look and see what kind of damage I'm dealing with here. There's a lot of scarring on the hood and the underside from capping and uncapping for many years. The barrel's in not too bad shape. I want to make sure that imprint remains, but there's no deep gouges on the barrel or the blind cap, just some scratching. 1500 didn't work, so we'll go with 400. So the 400 actually got those scratches out. So I'm going to do the whole front part of the hood with 400 to get all of those deep scratches out. So there we are. I've sanded out the scratches with 400 grit and then went over the whole thing with 1500 grit micromesh, and I think all the deep scratches are gone. And here is the end result after all the micromesh levels and some polishing compound. No scratches at all. Beautiful. So I've got all my parts cleaned up. The barrel is perfect, as is the end cap and the section. I installed the sack inside that cup and I was smart enough to Dremel it out just a tad to give it some room to put the new one in. I've trimmed this to 28.5 millimeters and we're going to put it back together again. Apply a little bit of talc. I'm using my pellet pusher from the Pendragons because it fits neatly inside that diameter of that sack, and we're going to push it back on itself. And I'll either fast forward this or cut to it because sometimes it takes a bit of teasing. There we go. That's what it's supposed to look like. I'm going to put a little silicone oil just on the edge of that cuff just to allow it to slide into the barrel. Little dab will do you on those threads as well. I put my Parker Vac extractor collet right there and we'll fit it into the barrel. I sort of twist it back and forth to get it started, and we want to make sure it's turning inside that barrel and not binding. Just give it hand tight. should be working. Put the blind cap on. We can put our clutch ring on the barrel, and then we're going to install the nib and feed. So we're going to put the siphon tube into the feed. There we go. And I've cleaned all that out, made sure that little hole is free of debris, and I've polished up that feed, and I polished up the nib. Let's look at that nib. Came out very, very nice. The imprint of the date is very, very faint. I can only see a 1, and there I can see a bit of the K from the 14K. Very, very faint imprint. Then we're going to put the feed and the siphon tube inside the collector so that the feed is upside down right at the large channel. There's a small channel right there and a large channel. Fit them in there, make sure it's tight and as far as it will go. I'm going to take the nib and put the slot on the bottom lined up with the large channel and push that in all the way. There we go. Looks good. Now we take our barrel with the clutch ring installed and fit it into the barrel. That's all we need to do right now. And we'll do a test fit of the hood. I'm going to line my thumb up with the tip of the hood. You can see that we're almost 180 degrees away. Try it again. And as tight as I can get it. And, well, the non-OCD would say that's perfect. But I say that's off just slightly. Perfect. And we put our cap on. And we're ready to fill. And let's do a quick overview of this pen before I provide some writing samples. I've shown the parts, features, and measurements of the Parker 51 Vacumatic in several videos. If you want a refresher on the Parker Vacumatic, its history, features, and measurements, just click on this video right here for those details. Some of the features varied from its introduction in 1941 through 1948, when it was replaced by the Parker Aerometric. This non-blue diamond split arrow clip is considered transitional as Parker dropped the lifetime warranty designation after the 1945 Supreme Court ruling. The back of the cap is engraved with 51, gold-filled, and made in Canada. The gold cap design is many courses of 5 parallel lines around the cap. These are very faint, as the cap must have been polished many times over the years, and evidenced by the many deep scratches that were in the hood. This pen was well used, being capped and uncapped many times through the years. There are several scrapes and knocks and slight dents on the cap, but it has stood the test of time very well and looks beautiful all polished up. The barrel and the hood are now scuff and scratch free. The imprint on the barrel is still very visible, as is the date code of the fourth quarter of 1946. Let's compare this 1946 Vacumatic 51 with an Aerometric model made 8 years earlier in the same Toronto Parker factory. This Parker 51 was part of a triple fountain pen, pencil, and jotter ballpoint set that belonged to my friend Ron's dad, Dennis. The most notable difference is the Parker clips, with the newer 51 sporting the longer arrow clip that replaced the split arrow clip around 1948. The engraving on the 1954 says Parker on the front and 1/10 12K gold filled on the back. And the 5 courses of lines converge at the top. The top jewels are made of the same materials, but the newer 51 is slightly larger. Uncapped, it's hard to tell them apart, but for the seam on the blind cap of the Vacumatic and the small hole at the base of the Aerometric. That hole is there to equalize the pressures so you don't squeeze the sack on the inside when you screw the barrel back on. And here is the Aerometric filler on the Parker 51 Aerometric. And it says Parker 51. To fill, press the ribbed bar firmly 4 times. Use dry writing super chrome ink. Please don't. Holding pen point down wipe point with soft tissue, the Parker Pen Company, made in USA. So it's interesting that the pen is made in Canada, but obviously some parts come from the USA. Now let's look at some writing samples. And we're back with the writing portion of the video. This is Clairefontaine 90 GSM paper, and this is a 1946 Parker 51 Vacumatic, and it has a 14 karat gold fine nib. Let's check the wetness. It's not all that wet. I'm going to try to make it wetter, but it's very smooth. That first skip there was me not having the pen in the right orientation. It's one of the tricky things about a hooded nib. Because you can't see that nib, it's hard to tell what your rotation is. That's why on the Parker 61, they put an arrow on there to point towards the nib. But this nib is very smooth, very nice, with good feedback. And the ink is Waterman's Serenity Blue. And so line variation, well, these nibs don't give any line variation. They give lines consistent with ball points because of the nature of the nib. The hooded nib does not flex at all. And the line this nib makes is 0.5 millimeters, which is bang on a Western fine or a Japanese fine to medium on my Richard Binder line width chart, which you can find linked in the description below. And for our quote, in some reverse writing, well, it's not doing it at all. It's actually smooth, but there's no ink. And some quick writing. No issues whatsoever, although the nib is a bit dry. Again, I'm going to work on that. And what are my thoughts on this restoration? Well, after the frustrations of the last two pen resurrections, this one was a pleasant change. The pen cleaned up beautifully. I was able to get all of the many deep scratches out of the hood and the blind cap, and the gold-filled cap and the beautiful split arrow clip polished up to a gleaming shine. The nib is smooth and relatively wet, and writes like it's brand new. I am going to work on getting that nib to write a little bit wetter. But these Parker 51 hooded nibs, in fine especially, are notoriously dry writers. But it's possible. After I ensured the nib was in working order, I added a liberal amount of silicone grease to that hood and screwed it back down again so that there are no leaks. And from its humble beginnings, this is now a gorgeous fountain pen. And there you have it. If you like this video, please like and subscribe, and don't forget to ring that bell to get instant notifications whenever a new video is posted. And you can join as a member of my channel too for only 99 cents a month, and I guarantee I'll answer your comments in the comment section, and you'll get cool emojis, badges, and sneak peek unboxing videos as well. And that just leaves it for me to say thank you for watching. And that's all she wrote.
I made this.